I was born into a singing family. Music was all around us all the time. We would be going down the road. I remember driving to my grandparents' house. The radio would turn off and we would all sing, you know, together. And I thought everybody was doing that at the time, but we were a little weird. And then at the same time, we were a house of faith as well. My papa was a preacher for 50 years before he passed away. So it was very natural that music and faith kind of melded together for us. And God really paved the way for me. I mean, not only with the opportunities that I had that just started to open up, but with the people that he put in my path. The best advice that I ever got, I look back, I tell people this all the time. I was singing at First Baptist Church, Houston, and John Bisogno was a pastor then. And I was talking to people after the service, and I turned around and he was right behind me. He was like, I'm a big guy. He was a huge guy, just huge, wide shoulders. And I was like, to his chest was right there. And he said, sing everywhere you can. And as simplistic as that is, that became my mantra. I'm gonna sing everywhere I can. I look back on that and I think, I mean, for me to be able to sing in Carnegie Hall and the Sydney Opera House and for the president at the White House and the O2 in London and in South Africa. And, you know, I just am amazed and so very grateful. I am grateful to be one of the voices that is out there making music, telling a story. I really am. First of all, I am and always have been a stylist. That affords me the ability to take a song and leave a little bit of my artistry on that. It has also made my music in my career very eclectic. I started out singing contemporary music, and my first independent project was contemporary, and then we did what we call the Blue Record, and those are very pop projects. And then I continued that with The Voice, and then at that same time I joined the Gaither Vocal Band, and was blessed to be able to lend my talent to that amazing, iconic group and do another thing that I do. This new project, I think of it, while someone who might have viewed through the lens of the vocal band and then this might think it's something new or even a departure, for me as a soloist, this is the next step on my development as an artist. This project is 15 songs, all of which I wrote. As far as stylistically goes, this is who I am. You know, and it's just the next step on that journey. Content-wise, I know that not all the songs on this project are gospel songs, but they are songs that are spiritual to me. They are songs about the human experience. The record starts out with the line, "This world is upside down. I never thought I'd be around in a time when we could hate and be told it's okay." It ends with, "I did it my way, you did it your way, and we came together and we lived in peace and harmony." That's no accident that this project is bookmarked with those two phrases. That's the first phrase and that's the last phrase. Hopefully these are crafted in a way that cause people to be moved.
Well, time respects no one. It can be so mean. It was his memory.
So many amazing stories that I have been blessed to have been told throughout the years by fans who have emailed me that have gone through similar experiences, had faced the horror of their loved one losing their memory, their cognitive ability, and the the joy that would so shine through when she sits there and she's waiting for him day after day, looking at all of the things that they have done together, and he comes back to her in that moment and shares the phrase that they have said so many times before. It's a beautiful story of humanity, it really is. I wrote Song for Sinners on a Sunday afternoon.
This is a song for sinners, saints and new beginners.
Went to church that morning with my family while worship music is going on around me, and I'm thinking, I don't feel like I can be that, you know? I don't feel like that I have it all together like that. I leaned over to my sweet wife, who has put up with so much over the years, and I said, you know, what I need right now is a song for sinners. And I went home and I wrote the lyric, this song for sinners, saints and new beginners, a song for the broken, we are not alone. And the idea is that this faith that we have is inclusive. It is for all of us. It is for the people who don't have it together and the people who think they have it together. And everyone in between. Church is a gathering of people who admit, I can't do this on my own. And if that song is for no one else, it's for me, that I am in need of that living water.
Sinners. For the losers and winners, a song for victims, lay your burden down. This is a song. I remember what we thought love was, and we were so young.
I remember what we thought love was the first song I wrote for this project. This is a song about my journey with my family and with the love of my life, and the ups and the downs, the imperfect journey that we have together. And I'm not trying to pretend to be a 20-year-old, you know? I have lived life. I have learned, and I am still learning. I've learned enough now that I'm going to keep learning, and that I know that I'll stumble along the way, and that I'll have to say I'm sorry, and that I will have times that we cherish so much together. And the last line of the song is, I remember what we thought love was, and I was so wrong. It was so much more.
And we were so wrong. It was so much more.
Sometimes you feel like you bare your soul, and was that worth it? And you live for the times when you bare your soul and it lifts somebody else up. And the truth is, I'm not trying to upend someone's life. I mean, I would never be that arrogant to think that I would have that kind of power. But if I can influence the next step on somebody's journey, if I can give them hope to stick with it, to hang in, and boy, I've heard stories of the darkest moments that someone's direction has been changed with a lyric of a song. If I can be a part of that, then I'll keep bearing my soul.